You'd think I'd have a plan by now. I don't. I ran some tests today. Alright, so about a week ago I got the Ninja 5, the Ninja 5 recorder for a couple hundred bucks off of Amazon. The reason I got that is because when I bought the A7S, one of the major differences between it and the sequel, the A7S II, was the 4K recording. The original A7S, which I have, does not support 4K recording, but it does support 4K output through an HDMI port. If you can capture that signal, you have a 4K image, which is what this is. See, the Ninja is just a recorder. It does a lot of other awesome stuff, but it's just a recorder. The many ways you can kind of wrap that recording in different formats and different file sizes and all stuff was overwhelming for someone who's never used it before. This is not scientific. Because there are so many other videos that have done it better than I ever could, I decided not to go that way. Instead, what I did is I am going to take a 10-second example from every single flavor of file that you can get off the Ninja besides ProRes RAW, because I know my camera doesn't support that, and literally just look for differences. I didn't change anything about any settings with the camera. I didn't change any ISO values or anything like that. Shot all in my preferred gamma, which in this case was Cine 4, I think. And kind of just did a blanket effect of the film, of a rough version of the film emulation pipeline I'm doing for Ava, to see if it falls apart. I mean, obviously YouTube is gonna compress the hell out of it, but this is my first native 4K video, so maybe there'll be a difference. Regardless, enjoy the next few minutes of me pretending to be Philip Bloom. Thank you.